to sexually explicit material without the consent of their parents. I made that view known to the museum. The museum can make their own decisions about their own direction and their own exhibits. I made my view known. It's up to the museum to decide now where they go.
That's James Moore. I'm talking about a sex exhibit at a museum here in Ottawa. MPs are hot and bothered over this sexually explicit exhibit that opened today at a federally funded museum, the Museum of Science and Technology. The Heritage Minister, James Moore, was highly critical, as you saw, of the provocative new display. It's called Sex, a tell-all exhibit. It's already been to Regina and Montreal. He called the exhibit an insult to taxpayers. Opposition MPs accused him of being, well, they say he's a prude, but after running without any controversy in Regina and Montreal, the new exhibit is causing a stir, and even though it's now been restricted to people 16 years and older. Now, a video piece about masturbation has been removed from it, but it raises questions. Is the National Science Museum an appropriate venue for this kind of exhibit? And is it appropriate for the minister to weigh in on the content of museums' decisions as to what to exhibit? Let's get MPs weighing in. Parliamentary Secretary to the Prime Minister, Dean Del Mastro, is here. NDP's Deputy Heritage Critic, Andrew Cash, is here. The Ontario Liberal MP, Carolyn Bennett, here. Gents and Carolyn Bennett, thanks for being here. Dean Del Mastro, what's the problem with this exhibit? Because we've talked to the museum. They say no federal funds go to this exhibit directly. They go to the museum itself. What's the problem here?
Well, first of all, it's beyond the scope of the mandate for the Museum of Science and Technology, whose mandate is to foster a greater understanding of science and technology, of which this is neither one of those. And of course, this museum is federally funded. It wouldn't exist without federal funds. Museums were their funding was specifically maintained through all of the deficit reduction action plan. So they were given a special free pass because of the value that they offer to Canadian taxpayers. We don't think that Canadian taxpayers feel that this is the appropriate venue. I can tell you I've heard from a significant number of my constituents on this issue that are quite upset about it.
Have you been there to see it?
Well, I think an awful lot of folks have actually had the opportunity to view it online and to see pictures and to actually read about what's there. They're deeply concerned about this kind of exposition being presented to young children. They think it's inappropriate, but it's really inappropriate for the Museum of Science and Technology. It's definitely not science and technology.
It's science.
It's called biology, Dean. It's called biology.
It's not biology, Dr. Bennett.
Well, Dean Del Mastro, they say, I'm just reading from what they said, it's a tactful approach. They say they developed this in this whole museum in conjunction with health specialists, medical doctors, a committee of experts, educational, sexologists, the whole, and they talk about life sciences and body science and biology. Well, should the government, without even seeing it in this case, should they really be commenting on the choices of a museum? I mean, is that wading too far into the process?
Well, Minister Moore did, in fact, take the opportunity, before he said anything about it, to go and see the exhibit to understand exactly what it was that was causing such a fuss. He looked at it, found it to be inappropriate for young children. And as I said, it's beyond the scope of the Museum of Science and Technology. Now, of course, I hear Carolyn kind of laughing again. She should take some of the angry calls from parents in my writing. Concern about this kind of material being presented to young children. I understand they have now changed the age, but even now, understanding that they have done something that the public finds unacceptable for young people to be seeing this, it still has to be asked, what does this have to do with science and technology?
All right, so Dean Del Mastro, you just said you didn't want to see it.
No.
I don't get, why not? Like, how do you want to comment on something that you may even see? I don't get that. Why?
Well, I've seen photos, and I believe you flashed some images of it. I mean, people can go to their average adult video store if they want to see.
Oh, but come on!
All this stuff they say jives with what's in curriculum for sex education in schools. Are you comparing this to pornography?
I think this goes quite a bit farther than what we see for sexual education in school. Certainly farther than what I received as far as sexual education in schools. But that's all. You think that's a problem, Carol? Yeah. You know what's a problem?
You know what is a problem?
Excuse me, Mr. Cash.
Go ahead.
Anyhow, what's really offensive with this, and this is why parents are calling a choice. And this is what the minister is in fact saying. We put in place a board. The board is there, and believe me, they are responsible to Canadian taxpayers. And what we're hearing from Canadian taxpayers overwhelmingly is that they don't feel that this is an appropriate expenditure of taxpayers' dollars. And it is certainly not science and technology.
But are you putting a chill, when the government says this, do you put a chill on curators and museums so the only thing they can show is what's aligned with what the minister likes?
Well, I think that when a museum is specifically given a mandate, and again, the mandate of this museum is to foster a greater understanding of science and technology. I'm not having anyone in my riding call me, I can assure you, and tell me that they think that this exhibit is science and technology.